Welcome everyone to Alpha Potato. Today I've got some giant news from the mobile gaming universe. Nier Automata director Yoko Taro's newest game is a dark fairy tale on mobile. Asus ROG Phone 3 set to be released on July 22. Apple scraps deals with some Apple Arcade devs in pursuit of more engagement. Capstone Games is working on a Man City soccer management game for mobile. The final EVE EchoS beta gets extended by a day following Google glitch. Pokemon Go developer Niantic is working on Catan World Explorers, and you can pre-register now. Warhammer Odyssey is heading into closed beta later this month. Metal Slug Code G is the TBD title of the next Metal Slug mobile game. And other many more news. Stay tuned. Okay, it's mobile gaming news time. Nier Automata director Yoko Taro's newest game is a dark fairy tale on mobile. Yoko Taro's mobile RPG Sinnoh Alice will finally see a worldwide release after an indefinite delay last year. The game was initially published in Japan back in 2017 by Nexon, and yet it would appear that the publisher wants nothing to do with the title anymore. And so Nexon is transferring the license to the original developer, Pokilabo. Asus ROG Phone 3 set to be revealed on July 22. We are still waiting for a precise date for the Lenovo Legion smartphone, but Asus has just revealed, courtesy of a timer on the ROG Phone 3 site, that we can expect that phone to be revealed on July 22. In the case of ROG Phone 3, we already know that the phone will have the latest Snapdragon 865 chipset, with up to 16GB of RAM and some RGB lighting. YouTube Kids is now available in 11 new countries, all located in the Central and South America. Here is the full list: Bolivia, Costa Rica, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, Nicaragua, Panama, Paraguay, and Uruguay. Elemental Dungeon is a neat mid-core roguelite that you should try. Controls are a bit like twin stick shooter. A joystick on the left lets you move, and a joystick on the right lets you fire. Around that right stick there are your elements. Select them to equip. So far so simple, but things get more interesting when you realize you can combine your elements. Apple scraps deals with some Apple Arcade devs in pursuit of more engagement. Apple is reportedly moving towards a retention-focused revamp of Apple Arcade future game lineup, a shift that seems to indicate that $5 per month subscription isn't sticking quite well as the company had hoped. The state of the mobile games industry in 2020. Last year, the global mobile gaming market grew to 68.5 billion. This growth was influenced by several underlying factors, making experts believe that the numbers will continue soaring this year. You can read this article on techzone360.com, links in the description. Capstone Games is working on a Man City soccer management game for mobile. Manchester City, the second best soccer team in UK, has agreed a partnership with Capstone Games. The results will be a management game in Asia Pacific, North America and UK. This Is the Police, Rebel Cops and Titan Quest are discounted again on Android. In a move that can only be described as frequent, Handy Games has once again discounted three of its best mobile titles. Rebel Cops is a recently released sequel. It's another story-driven tactical action game in which you straddle the thin blue line. Throughout this time, your goal is vigilante justice rather than a comfortable retirement. You can pick the Rebel Cops for $5.49, down from $7.99. Monument Valley-inspired puzzler Space will be out any minute now on Android, and this time we have a trailer for you guys. Space, the Polish new puzzler from the developer Subpixels, as frequently happens on mobile, Space has managed to arrive on the iOS App Store on its scheduled release date, but remains stubbornly absent from Google Play. Both versions were due today, July the 2nd, so it should be along presently. The final Eve Echo S beta gets extended by a day following Google glitch. Eve Echo S, the delay hit mobile spin-off of a huge popular PC MMO, has just entered its final closed beta prior to launch. The beta was initially supposed to last for 10 days, but owing to a short delay, the morning results from a glitch that stuck Google backend system, publisher NetEase is giving beta players an extra day with the game as well as an additional 2 million skill points. If Echoes takes place in a parallel plane of reality to the original EVE Online, it seems you're building outposts, trading, completing missions, mining, and so on. Pokemon Go developer Niantic is working on Catan World Explorers, and you can pre-register now. Niantic, the forward-thinking studio behind the hugely popular Pokemon Go, as well as Ingress and Harry Potter Wizards Unite, is working on an AR spin-off of popular board game Catan. You have link in description for pre-register. Warhammer Odyssey is heading into closed beta later this month. Set in the old world Warhammer timeline, Warhammer Odyssey will see players joining mercenary companies and taking on the doomsday of the more sleep, the Chaos Moon. There will be 3 races and 6 classes to choose from, and several iconic locations to explore. Kenny-san, Puzzler Peak Edge, is available on Google Play Store. Full disclosure, it's been out for several days, but we missed it the first time around. You can download Peak's Edge for free right now on Android Play. Popular sci-fi strategy game Stellaris: Galaxy Command is out now on Android. Stellaris: Galaxy Command, the popular and highly acclaimed sci-fi RPG from Paradox Interactive, it's available to download on the Google Play Store. Originally released on PC in 2016, before making the jump to consoles last year, Stellaris is what's known as a grand strategy game. Stellaris: Galaxy Command is free to download. Metal Slug Code G is the TBD title of the next Metal Slug mobile game. The next Metal Slug game on mobile will be called Metal Slug Code G, maybe. The title isn't confirmed at this stage. Developed by Tencent's subsidiary Timi Studio, which appeared on these pages last week thanks to the involvement with the forthcoming Pokemon Unite, Metal Slug Code G will be a side-scrolling arcade shooter with sleek 2.D visuals. Breath of the Wild inspired action RPG Genshin Impact enters in the last closed beta. Genshin Impact, an action RPG from the Chinese studio miHoYo, is entering its final closed beta next week, taking it one step closer to a global launch. The game, which is also heading to iOS, PS4 and PC, sees you romping around in a vast cartoonish render fantasy open world, mostly killing stuff. miHoYo promises a cast of lively characters and plenty of exploration. Guys, this is it. The best news of this week. Thank you for watching. A subscribe or a like is always appreciated, and as always, you are awesome. Till the next episode from the mobile gaming industry, please don't break your phone.